This is a bonus episode of Making Sunday Happen, encouragement for church content creators with Brian Blackmore and Eric Bramlett. Let's do it.
This is the definitive podcast for helping you plan, create, and execute dynamic worship experiences at your church. Useful, practical content in the areas of production, worship, communications, first impressions, and more. This is Making Sunday Happen.
Welcome to this bonus episode of Making Sunday Happen. This week, I welcome my friends Brian Blackmore and Eric Bramlett. Brian is the head of Church Production Magazine. If you are in the church tech world at all, I strongly encourage you to check them out when you can. They have fantastic articles and resources available to the church, specifically church tech and production folks, so be sure to check them out. Eric is the creative arts lead at Community Christian Church in Illinois and will be a speaker at the Capture Summit along with Brian coming up in just a few weeks in Raleigh, North Carolina. This is a conference for church filmmakers and church content creators. So more information about the summit as the podcast rolls along today. I'll be talking with Brian and Eric all about the status of church content creators. Where are we at? Are we feeling burnout? Are we seeing more demands on us still? What's it like to continue to produce content and also execute great physical and online worship experiences at the same time? Brian and Eric are going to give some great encouragement on that topic today. So we'll dive right into my interview with Brian and Eric right after this. Check this out. Hey guys, Carl here. I want to tell you about an ebook I wrote called 25 Ways to Use Video at Your Church. Stats show that video is how we consume most all of our information and entertainment. Video is an incredible medium to use to share the gospel. We can use video to share powerful stories and create amazing worship experiences at our church. In this book, I give you 25 creative ways that you can use video at your church to play in your worship experiences, on your website, on your social media platforms, and more. I've produced over 2,000 videos for churches around the world, and I've led our team at 1230 Media to make hundreds more. We are the church's leading source for custom media content. I don't say that to brag. I say that to say we know what types of videos that churches are using because they're coming to us quite a bit to produce them. Now, you're not only going to get ideas for types of videos that you can produce, like sermon bumpers, series trailers, song videos, testimonies, and more. I also share ideas for how to implement these elements into your worship experiences and the ministries of your church. So I want you to pick up a copy of the book today at 1230.media/books. That's 1230.media/books. Hey guys, today I welcome Brian Blackmore and Eric Bramlett. Brian is the editor at Church Production Magazine and also the presenter of the Capture Summit, which is happening August 3rd and 4th this year. Also, Eric is the creative arts director at Community Christian Church in Illinois. Guys, welcome. Thanks so much for hanging out.
Thanks, Carl.
Absolutely. So much.
Great to be here.
So excited to be here.
Now, Brian, you and I were talking recently about just kind of the state in which content creators and filmmakers, especially at churches, find themselves in, especially over the last year. You know, just so many demands and so much going on. In fact, our team has grown significantly in the past year, and I'm always looking for more designers and video guys. And kind of the rub that we always face is the demand is so high, and to find good guys that are not either burn out or have time to help is interesting to find. So I'd love for you to, Brian, let's start with you. How would you speak to that?
Imagine that situation if you're a church that's relying on volunteers, or if you're
exactly right.
A film team leader that's in a volunteer capacity and relying on all volunteers, or if you're a small to medium sized church where there might be one or two staff members and you know the rest is you're sort of sent to figure it out yourself. So
right.
It's really interesting to think about how it's changed in the last 2 years, where we were, you know, in summer of 2019 versus where we are in summer 2020 and now 2021, how that landscape has changed dramatically for the church content creator. And, you know, we're happy to be presenting the Capture event August 2nd or August 3rd and 4th of this year. And we hope to provide some sense of renewal and some sense of, passion and new potential direction as this, the monkey wrench that the pandemic has put in our way. Yeah. So Eric was one of our keynoters last year, and he's going to be speaking again this year. And as a creative pastor, somebody who kind of spans bridges the gap between senior leadership and the tech folks, I just think he's in such a unique position. And we had a conversation a couple of weeks ago about this, and that's why I thought he would be perfect to come on and kind of illustrate the context in which Capture's trying to address this situation for the church. So Eric's a creative pastor at Christian Community Church in Chicago, large multi-site church, and you know has a large church mentality, but also a small church mentality because of what's going on in the multi-sites. So Eric, maybe, you know, I hate to ask you to reconstruct that conversation from a couple of weeks ago, but what do you see in, the stresses in the day to day of the church content creator this year compared to last, maybe compared to 2019?
Sure. Thanks so much, Brian. Yeah. You know, it's fascinating. I mean, I think all of us went from, you know, if you were in a video role in a church, and I oversee a video team that puts out videos, you know, so you're talking testimony videos, you're talking concept videos, bumper videos, you know, you might've been doing, you know, in a busy season, maybe two videos of maybe 2 minutes to 5 minutes, maybe each week. And that was kind of the workload, and it was plenty. And then all of a sudden everything was shut down, and maybe you had been doing some live streaming prior to that and you could simply just turn that on. But for many of us, it was like we had gone from making a couple videos a week to basically producing a 50 to an hour long television show every Sunday. And, for us in our context, we did that for 50 straight weeks. Fortunately, we pivoted in a way that was, you know, where everyone came on board, the adrenaline was high. We wanted to do what was right, and we wanted to, you know, be able to move the mission forward. And so we did that. And then you get to, like, for us, it was around the last week of February where we went back into the locations and you begin that rebuilding process of like being back in the building. Well, guess what? Online isn't going away. The 50 minute to an hour long, you know, service online, right, is not going away. And so how do you, with the same team, you know, be able to accommodate, you know, both of these realities? And it's one thing to say we have a hybrid church where you can kind of go back and forth. But then do you have a hybrid staff? And then, you know, what are the ramifications of that? And I think that, the thing that I noticed, of course, is that, you know, adrenaline will only get you so far. And so you start to run out of gas and you start to run out of steam, and it becomes very, very difficult. And we had some rough times of trying to negotiate, what clearly was the right thing to do, but can you do that with the structure that you have? And do you have to think about these things a lot differently?
Yeah, you make a good point. And Brian, you brought up renewal. Eric, what do you think about the status of people's maybe emotional state? Are we tired? Are we burnt out? Are we trying to figure out, okay, I got through that, but what's next? And can I, can I take it?
Right. Well, I mean, first of all, I think I think we all need to give ourselves permission to have lived through a pandemic, you know, regardless of where your sort of environment was, you know, whether you were in a state that, you know, maybe had low restrictions and so it kind of didn't feel like that was really happening, or if you were in a very, you know, highly restricted state. Either way, everything that was happening, you add to the pandemic the social unrest, you add to it a very contested election, you know, we had a lot of things that were hitting our brains, and really honestly I think you know, it's on all of us, I think, to figure out what do I need to do to sort of get right with my spirit, get right with my mind. You know, we have been affected by this, and part of it, you know, it's not unlike any kind of recovery. The part of it is admitting that it took place. And so, I mean, I think that's part of the process. You know, if you just simply go right back to where you were and say, yep, okay, I just did a blip, and now it's, you know, we went from March 2019 to, you know, July 2021. I mean, that's not going to help. That's not going to help you. And it's not even really where we're at. We're in such a different place than we were back then.
I think, you know, we're called to serve with a joyful heart. And sometimes that's tough. And I think we need to take some of this upon ourselves to go through some steps. And like Eric said, you know, give yourself permission to, you know, freak out a little bit, or to it's almost like grief. Allow yourself to go through some stages that, you know, that will provide a transition in a healthy sort of way from where things were in 2019 to where things are 21. It's almost like, you know, it's almost like a grief stage. You can't go back. It's different. And we have to, you know, take steps to move forward as well.
So before I get into, I'd love to talk about how Capture is going to kind of help renewal process for us. Eric, let me ask you this. As far as our current environment, where do you think, and you mentioned the, you know, hybrid. Now, obviously, online's not going anywhere. So now we have to do both. So where do you think the not only the spirit of content creators are, or maybe the amount of work that we're having to create? Kind of give me a status of our current environment.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's a lot. It's a lot. I think that there's an opportunity. You know, I think many of our content creators are within the church, whether they're volunteers, whether they're leading a volunteer team, they're the chief storytellers. And I think that there's a huge opportunity to actually elevate some of that into what we would normally think of pastoral ministry. You know, I mean, if you think about the structures that many churches have, you know, you have your pastors and then you have your doers that are kind of do the stuff. And in a lot of cases, those content creators, the video teams, the tech teams, lighting, editing, audio, like all of those things are kind of within the doer thing. I think what you're going to start to see is in hybrid church, those artists are the storytellers. They are the pastors. They are pastoring and telling stories and these parables. Now they may show up, you know, as, you know, 30-second blips on Instagram, you know, but social media now we know is not just, you know, a picture and a verse. It's so much more. And so I think if churches can figure out how to invest and build up that side of what their mission is and how it moves forward, I think that could help in terms of the renewal and feeling like, okay, I'm doing all of this work, but where is the reward, or where is the, you know, where is the ownership, and how is the church sort of responding to that? Because I think that otherwise you will have burnout. You will have just kind of a feeling of, you know, and as you mentioned, Carl, at the beginning, I mean, so many are are in demand, that I think what you'll have, if you don't figure out how to turn that, you'll end up having so much turnover in essentially the job market, because it'll feel like, well, this is not a really healthy place, and so I'm going to switch over and see if I can find another place. And because those artists might be in high demand, you know, there's an opportunity over there, there's an opportunity over there, there's an opportunity over there. But the question will be whether or not that environment can actually foster a healthy experience for those storytellers.
So you bring up one good point. So I remember I was at a, this has been probably 10 years ago, I was at a church in Mississippi, and I was one of the only, if not the only content creator for a church of, we ran about 15 to 20,000 on a weekend. And I remember having that thought that, like, besides the senior pastor and any other maybe teaching team that's on stage, I felt the weight of being responsible for being a pastor, in that I was the storyteller. Besides any other of the teaching pastors, I'm the one who has to craft the stories that the entire congregation at every campus sees. Now, of course, there are checkpoints along the way and approvals and things like that, but still, I felt that weight. And I think that a lot of content creators, especially right now in this moment, feel that weight of, I'm a part of the teaching team, I'm a part of the storytelling team, in a much bigger way than I might have been a year and a half ago. Brian, you want to speak to that at all?
Yeah, I think it's absolutely true. There's a, you know, I think a healthy situation is collaboration between the, you know, the teaching pastor and the video team, you know, at least the lead video producer, because sometimes it comes down to what, I mean, I've heard it, you know, explained to me that sometimes the video team helps guide the teaching pastor's message, because there may be certain points that can be illustrated better through video that might be better to include in the message, rather than just taking what the teaching pastor had wanted to include in the message, and that be something that's very hard to illustrate by way of video. So
yeah, that's a great point.
Absolutely. Collaboration. It's, you know, I think for the really healthy situations have that healthy collaboration.
So tell me,
Go ahead,
Eric. Were you going to speak?
Well, I was just going to say the collaboration. That's exactly right. And being able to be in the room together, whatever the phase is of the development of the content, is so, so important. And that there is communication between what's happening with teaching, what's happening with music, and what's happening with production. You know, all of those entities need to be on the same page. You can work in silos, you know, to get stuff done. But if you're not talking to each other, and if you're not having some kind of regular rhythm, then what'll happen is, you know, someone will go off on a path that they didn't realize was something that they shouldn't,
right.
or just it becomes a different narrative. And if you're already siloed, then in general, the senior pastor silo is going to win. Right. And so then you've got, now you're building some battles between some of these entities, instead of, like, if we started from the very beginning in collaboration, then we can go off and do our things and regroup and go, how are we doing? You know, how is it going?
Right. Good point. Brian, that's why I'm really excited about this Capture event, is because it really gives us a place to come together as a community, where we can all feel each other's pain a little bit of, yes, I know what the last year has been like. I know the demands of the content that's been on me, and you can relate to that. So I think the community piece and the networking piece, and also just encouragement pieces of the summit are just some of the things that I'm encouraged to see. Do you want to speak to that?
We're excited. I mean, we're hoping for 500, you know, hopefully more content creators, you know, video producers, creative pastors, technical and production people as well. The event is in Raleigh, North Carolina. It's actually Apex, which is a suburb of Raleigh. You can find out more at capturesummit.com. So we want to come together and, you know, have that networking time and put you in touch with some great vendors that are on going to be on site. We have about 15 vendors that are going to be on site: Sony, Canon, Teradek, Small HD, a bunch of Black Magic, there's other companies like that that are going to be, you know, there for people to, you know, to see and experience what the latest products that they have, latest tools. Yeah, so we hope for at least 500 in person, and again that many in the online, the streaming hybrid version that we're going to be producing as well. So
awesome.
August 3rd and 4th, would love to have everybody come. Eric's going to be there, Carl's going to be there, I'm going to be there. Let's come have some fun.
Yeah, capturesummit.com, is that correct, Brian?
That's correct.
Awesome. Well, you guys check out the summit. Really excited about it. If you're a content creator at your church, if you're a filmmaker in the ministry world at all, this is a great place for you to come and just sit under some great speakers, get some great community, network with some great folks and some great vendors. So we're really excited about it. I hope you guys check it out. Again, capturesummit.com is the website. Well, Brian, Eric, thank you guys so much. I appreciate the time today very much.
Thanks, Carl.
Thank you, Carl.
Hey guys, I want to tell you about a really cool conference that I'll be a part of in a few weeks. It's called the Capture Summit. It's for church filmmakers and content creators. It's August 3rd and 4th in Raleigh, North Carolina. And speakers include filmmakers Eric Bramlett, Josh Etheridge, Laura Tapp, Jesse Henning, my friend Brian Blackmore from Church Production Magazine, and more. You can register at capturesummit.com. Be sure to get there if you can. If not, be sure to catch the live stream. Again, the website capturesummit.com. Here's a quick video with more details. If you're listening to the audio of this podcast, be sure to go to makingsundayhappen.com to watch the video and learn more, or register at capturesummit.com. Check this out.
The show notes for this episode are available now at makingsundayhappen.com.
Hey guys, thanks so much for checking out this bonus episode of Making Sunday Happen. We love you guys. Continue to go out there and create some incredible worship experiences at your church this weekend. I'll catch you next time.
Making Sunday Happen is a production of the Ministry of 1230 Media. For show notes, archive episodes, and more free resources for your church, visit MakingSundayHappen.com.